guys, Lloyd Owen here, and I just received this Palm Pre from HP, and I took this cover off, which goes like around the box like that. Okay, as you can see here, on the front it's got a picture of the Palm Pre. It's got a protective seal on this side, so I'm just going to get a knife. Okay, so once you take the protective seal off, there is also one on the other side, but okay, so when you open the phone, you get this, which is the actual phone, which has got a see-through cover case thing on it. Once you take that out, obviously you get the phone. It's a lot smaller than what I thought. It fits nicely in your hand. It's actually got a screen peel thing off, which I'll peel off in a second. Okay, so when you slide it up, the slider's a little bit tight to start off with. I have used this before, and it's quite sturdy, and the edges are, they're not that sharp. I mean, a lot of people say they're sharp, but I don't really find them that sharp. And typing on the Palm Pre, I think it's amazing. I mean, I've tried it on the in the O2 shop, and I actually thought this was easy to type on. A lot of people say it's a little bit cramped, but my fingers are only small, so it doesn't really matter. And on the back here, you have the shiny surface. If I slide it down, on the back here, you have the camera and the speaker, which you can see. If I just take the back off, if I know how to do this. Okay, I'm not going to take the back off. Okay, so in here, you have these starting documents. So just take these out. Okay, so inside you have this Palm Pre charger here with orange wrapping. You also have the USB cable and the headphones. I'm not going to take them out, I'm just going to leave them in there. Oh, and also this case which I just took out. Okay, so I'm going to put it back in a sec. Move that over here. So we're going to get to the phone right now. Okay, so to turn this phone on, you press this power button up here. I'm not sure if you can see that, but you hold that down, and as you can see, the Palm logo thing comes up. Takes a little while to boot. I mean, it's nothing crazy, I doubt. Slider's a little sort of not sticky, just a little bit stiff. But I have actually heard it loosens up a little bit. Okay, so the bottom light just started to flash. It's a little bit longer because it's the first boot, probably. It's not going to take this long usually, I hope. It's just a flashing Palm logo at the moment. I'm actually going to cut this, so check SIM. So, I haven't got a SIM card in here right now. First impressions, it's pretty cool, I suppose. If this this whole bar down here, that hope little button there lights up too. I just got it lighted up somehow. There you go, it lights up, and that's the back gesture. I have heard about that. And if you, it's hard to do, if you drag up from there, the menu actually moves up and down. I just opened up the email client, I think. Ah, what's up with the brightness? And as you can see there, you can swipe up then to get rid of it. I can open up like the phone app, for example, and it brings me into a dialer, which I can, it's a pretty responsive screen with the numbers. I can just dial. It's not going to dial, I haven't got a SIM card, and I get a little error message there. But yeah, overall, I mean, it's a good phone. If you want to close applications, you just press that button and swipe up. Sorry, press that button, swipe up. Kind of missed there. But yeah, I actually like this phone. If you're thinking of getting it, I wouldn't really hesitate. I have heard of the WebOS. It's awesome as it is. There is an app store, which used to be pretty small, but now it's actually grown, and it is quite big. There are a lot of apps available on there, and I mean, all the apps that you're going to need is going to be on there. Obviously, it's not going to be as big as the iPhone. But, yeah. Overall, I think this phone is good. I'm not just saying this because I just unboxed it, but I have used one before. So, yeah. Hope this helped any of you. And goodbye.